I started out to do a quick valve cover gasket replacement on this Toyota. However, what I saw under the valve cover is the reason for this video: engine sludge. I'll go through the causes of engine sludge and share some of the steps that you can take to prevent buildup. Now let's get this. Sludge is a combination of degraded engine oil, dirt, and other contaminants like moisture, coolant, and so on and so forth. These combine to form the dark gelatinous substance. Sludge is bad for engines because it can block oil passageways, variable valve timing solenoids, oil pickup screens. This ends up inhibiting lubrication and further accelerates engine wear. Here are some of the practices that encourage sludge buildup and some of the preventive steps you can take. The first is infrequent oil changes. Engine oil degrades and oxidizes under the increased temperature that it faces in the engine. The resultant reactive compounds combine with contaminants, as I said before, and form sludge. Skipped or delayed oil changes means that the accumulation of these oxidized products continue, encouraging sludge formation. Secondly, having low engine oil levels. This will make the low oil work much harder and increase the proportion of degraded components in the oil to good oil. This is why keeping up with regular oil change intervals, as well as ensuring that the engine oil is set at the proper level, are best practices. Thirdly, excessive idling and short stop and go trips. These conditions prevent the engine from reaching operating temperature and the flow of oil remains sluggish within the engine. Combined with the fact that there may be some initial formation of sludge in the engine, the sluggish flow only encourages more sludge. Fourth, use of poor quality oil or wrong oil weight. Using the correct oil weight for your car is highly recommended. Good oils usually have a high percentage of antioxidants and detergents, which reduce the rate of oil degradation and also help to keep any degraded compounds suspended in the oil, as against having them form clumps. This is where using synthetic oil can be an advantage. Synthetic oil is more resistant to thermal degradation compared to conventional oil and will usually have more additives to resist sludge formation. While I'm not saying every engine should use synthetic oil, regular oil changes according to your manufacturer and keeping the oil levels where they should are the more important things. 5. Coolant head gasket leaks. This simply introduces moisture past the head gasket into the combustion chamber, which will eventually leak past the piston rings and into the oil pan, where it encourages sludge formation. If your coolant level continues to reduce and you're unable to find any external leaks, be sure to check for the integrity of the head gasket through a compression test. I have a video on how to do a compression test with just a scanner for some vehicles, and I'll have the link on the screen. 6. Excessive blow-by gases from worn piston rings or clogged PCV valves. Similar to the coolant scenario we just talked about, the blow-by gases contaminate the oil and at the end of the day combine with the highly reactive oxidized oil to form sludge. This is why, in terms of tune-ups, cleaning or changing out your PCV valve is something you shouldn't skip. 7. You just have to know that there are some engines that were poorly designed and are more prone to sludge. If you have any one of these cars, using synthetic oil is definitely one upgrade I would consider. Finally, what do you do if you already have engine sludge? There's a long-running debate on what to do, with one side focusing on using engine flushes and the other on a slower approach through the use of synthetic oil. Depending on the degree of sludge formation, you may also have to loosen the oil pan and check that the oil pickup screen is not clogged. However, since this video is more on the preventive side, I won't be focusing on what to do if you already have engine sludge, even though I did go ahead to use an engine flush on this particular car. Hope that you take some time to pay attention to these things that lead to engine sludge formation. Catch you on the next one. Peace!